Welcome to another episode of Personal Space, you guys, the show where I love to introduce you to my favorite girl bosses. Today, we are going rogue with Rogan. Rogue today. Wanted to introduce you to my friend Rogan, a new blogger. She used to be my boss, y'all, so this is kind of weird. It's kind of weird sitting here right now interviewing her on this level, but this is Rogan. Hello. She's a former news editor, former news reporter, my former boss, my former editor, pretty much a lot to do with how I, a lot of farmers, but a lot to do with how I am able to be who I am today. I love to pay homage, love to say thank you to those people who have been so instrumental in my life. But Rogan is now a vlogger.
Yeah.
And this is why we are sitting here. Y'all know I love me a good old girl boss. I love someone who just takes life by the horn and say, here, take that.
Say, here.
Take it, Rogan. Welcome to Personal Space.
I am so happy to be here. I'm honored. Thank you so much. I tell you, you know how to hype a girl up
for
it. Getting nervous. Now she got me hyped.
So thank you so much for being here. You have gone from all of those things I just mentioned just now, and now you are a blogger.
Yes.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the field.
You're the fairy blog mother, as you put. So thank you so much for welcoming me.
What has it been like, that transition from hardcore news, hardcore girl boss, to now more fun, colorful blogger?
Child. Let me tell you something. First of all, it's exciting. I welcome it with open arms. I got kind of tired, I'm going to be honest with you. Like, I still love news. I have a passion for news in that sense. But I got so tired of going on the murder scenes. I got so tired of dealing with the politicians. Mm-hmm. And so it feels really good to be able to talk about the fun things and the things that matter to me, the things that people want to hear and to get their feedback. I just absolutely love it. And I'm just looking forward to seeing myself grow.
Yeah, so tell me about your blog, This Bahamian Gyal.
Yes, so I formed my blog. I started my blog about a year and a month ago. So I'm a baby.
Yay!
I'm a baby. And I say that it's creative jambalaya just because I just have so many creative elements on it. I talk about relationships, marriages, I talk about politics from time to time, all the hot button issues that we experience, all the pop culture references that we make on social media, that makes its way to the blog. I like to talk about my reality talk shows, and so I like to keep it real, so I say it's truth serum with a dose of humor.
Yeah.
And so I just absolutely love it.
And I think I asked you this before in another setting. How do you feel, or what are your thoughts on going from news editor, news anchor to just a blogger, like some people like to say?
Yeah, and I can't stand when someone says just a blogger. So that's like saying just a doctor to me, because
so
it's a very serious profession that we're in, and we are changing lives, believe it or not.
Mm-hmm.
People wouldn't understand that, but a lot of people tune into blogs because they want to know what's going
on.
Some people tune into blogs exclusively. They never make it to CNN or
that
MSNBC.
Is so true.
So that's where they get their news most of the time. But I feel good because I get to interact with people. I didn't typically get to interact with individuals that much when I was in news, believe it or not. But on this level, I like the interaction. I like the feedback from people. And I love being able to talk about a wide variety of topics and not just the regular run-of-the-mill.
Yeah. And I think for me, one of the reasons why I started my blog a while ago is because when I got home, I wanted something different.
An escape.
An escape. And so I feel you. I am right there with you with the tide of the murder scenes and the politicians and all that stuff. And so I'm like, where can I go to read about hair and nails and Stevie J and Jocelyn and all that stuff? So I'm like, you know what? I don't have it, so let me create it.
Oh my God. You're speaking my language right now. Like, I always said I wanted to go to like a happy place on the internet. And sometimes it could get a little negative. Like, I love my MTO, Media Takeout, my little ratchet MTO and the gossips and stuff. But sometimes they get a bit negative. So I like to have something where I can have great entertainment, but at the same time, it's uplifting, it's positive, and so I wanted to create that space as
and
well.
More so than creating it for me, I wanted to create it for other people.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think about that relationship and that unifying in the blogosphere? Have you been able to reach out to other bloggers and just kind of, you know, connect and collaborate?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, I'm staying in touch with you. I always stay in touch with you, but other bloggers as well, because I'm a fan of people.
Yeah.
I'm a fan of creatives, and so every time I'm on social media, I always I'll hit them up and say, you know what, I like what you're doing, or I'll comment on something that they've done, because I don't get the jealousy thing. I'm not interested in that. That's a wasted emotion. And so I'm not interested in just being like, oh, she's doing a great job, let me keep that to myself. Mm-hmm. That doesn't benefit the person. Mm-hmm. It's good to say, Ayanthi, I love what you're doing. I follow what you're doing and get tips.
Yeah.
You know, so I love the interaction that I've had, but I do see some bloggers kind of keep their distance, and I wish that that would change, and I hope it changes in the coming years.
So happy that you took your journalism expertise and you took your love of news and your love of being on TV and being a writer and turned it into this. Yep. I always wanted this for more of my journalists, more of my local. I always wanted, I'd be like, y'all have the platform.
Yep.
You have the people who already know you.
Yeah.
You already have that stage. Like, take it to another level. And very few of us do that.
I remember reading one of your blogs and you talked about that very same thing. You said, you see so many people in the industry who are so talented. They have so much to offer, but they're going to stay stagnant in that profession rather than branching out. And those individuals do, and you said it, they do kind of turn up their noses, and it's just the weirdest thing. We're all writers.
The minute I left mainstream news and I became a blogger, I felt almost excommunicated from our industry. No, for real. Like that's a harsh word.
But that's how I felt.
I felt like people were turning up their noses at me, looking down on me. What the hell she thinks she doing? A blogger, really? Like, it was almost like I was a Junsa walking into like this big black tie affair. And you know what? I walked into every affair the same. Every media invitation, I was there because I'm still a part of this.
Yeah, you're still part of the group. I don't understand it, and it's not like your talent left when you went into a different
sphere.
Your talent didn't go anywhere. If anything, it's amplified.
It's being diversified.
It's being diversified and amplified because it takes a great talent to be able to go from news to say, I'm going to talk about lipstick and make that sound like popping, to talk about world affairs, to talk about whatever it is that you're talking about, travel. You have to have serious skills. A lot of people are very one note.
Yeah.
And so I salute you. I tip my hat to you in that vein.
Do you feel that way, though? Has that happened to you?
It hasn't happened yet, but I could, you know what? Let me take that back. I haven't had it from my journalism colleagues, but I've had it from colleagues in other areas who go, what the hell is girl thinks she's doing with her life? That's what you're doing? And so it's just like, you don't get it. You won't understand it. You won't get the dream. So I don't need to keep explaining myself to you. I just need to keep putting in the work, doing what I have to do. And you will see eventually.
Awesome. You'll see. All right. Now, one of the ways me and Rogan could connect on any level, on any day, is when we talk about our favorite reality TV shows and our favorite personalities, right? The ratchetness is be going on in the midnight when we get to talking. So a couple of things I wanted to put on the table and discuss. You know, my girl, first of all, Wendy Williams.
Okay, there's a part of me that feels sorry for her as a woman, right? I feel sorry for her as a woman because I wouldn't want anybody to go through that. And understand, you got to walk out on camera every single day, 5 days a week. That must be really tough. But it's of her own making at the same time. It's not for me to get into her marriage, but from the outside, it just looks so terrible. And I wish Wendy would just kind of give herself the advice that she would give to somebody if they were saying, hey, Wendy, I got a question for you.
Yeah.
And just kind of walk away from that situation.
So I hear you, right?
Yeah.
I hear you, and I get you.
I know you so disagree. Go ahead.
I kind of have to almost disagree.
Yeah, go ahead.
We love Wendy because
she's ratchet.
She's ratchet, and she loves to gossip, and she likes to talk everybody business, right? Mm-hmm. But she gets paid to do that.
Yes.
Right? She gets paid to just go in on people, on their lives, their marriages, their husbands, their bankruptcy, and all that stuff, right? And I don't know anybody who literally sits down and puts their own mess on the table, per se.
No, nobody puts their own mess on the table. But once they go through their own mess, it gives them a different perspective as to what somebody is going through.
Yeah, second person I want to chat about, your boyfriend, R. Kelly.
I got so much mana. I know which one you're
your
talking
boyfriend,
about.
R. Kelly.
Oh, the aura?
The aura.
Kales?
What happened? The rain is coming.
What happened? R. Kelly. Oh, my God. Again, the chickens are coming home to roost. Is that how the saying goes? R. Kelly has had a long rope for a number of years, and now it's finally caught up with him.
Talk about the people who have supported him over the years, even in the face of these. Y'all, it is raining so hard. But wait, listen, this is what
let's go.
Even in the face of these allegations, right? We have a photo with R. Kelly from a couple of years ago.
I know.
How do you feel?
Girl, do you know what was so funny? I posted that picture on Instagram.
I saw.
And I said, I don't know if you remember, but I asked him, I said, Mr. Kelly, can you take a picture of me? And he turned around and he said, sure. It was so creepy.
Creeped out by that?
Yes,
I saw your blog moment. About that, you know.
Yes. Like, I was happy to take the picture, but I remember going home and saying, my sister, you're kind of creepy. Like, I
said
that, but it was only years later when this happened.
It is raining. It is raining. Our producer is saying, keep going. You like this?
Yeah, it's different. We gangsta.
We are in the rain.
Yes.
Personal space getting it done anyway. Yes. Rogan, thank you so much. This has been fun.
It's been really good.
I don't want want either of us to get sick. But thank you so much. Thank you. And congratulations on everything. She is also an award-winning and award-nominated local blogger.
Let me tell you who to say congratulations to. The fairy blog mother right here just got her back. So she hit him like Drake. Back to back. Elevation
back award. Back to back.
So big up to Iantia and big up to all the
Thank you. And we are out because the rain is down.